Soccer is a world sport. In almost every country in the world, people play or are fans of soccer. Whether it is the ruthless crowds chanting their team's melodic fight song in unison, or entire countries coming to a standstill as they watch their team battle to win the World Cup, soccer brings people together. Growing up in the one country where soccer isn't the major sport wasn't easy. Still, a group of 22 kids and two coaches were able to create a family that gained support, attracted fans, and united many over a short six-month season. This family started in the hot, dry months of June and July in the two-hour team camps and summer league games every week. Although nobody liked going to these stagnant camps and futile games, we managed to edge Lamont in penalty kicks to win the summer league championship. Little did we know that this group of juniors and seniors was starting to become a family and had massive amounts of potential. Throughout the first weeks of the season, we had trouble playing and communicating with one another. What does a group do to try and create a sense of family and camaraderie? Two words, road trip. Unfortunately for us, this road trip was a six-hour drive to Quincy, Illinois, aka the middle of nowhere. Trying to get over the fact that we were driving 6 hours to play three pointless games, we began some team activities on and off the bus. Whether it was watching the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles battle the Shredder, or figuring out who sleeps where and how they position their body in that space, our team soon became a family. Other highlights and positive activities included watching the sun slowly drop beyond the horizon over the deserted cornfield and having Borat as our bus driver. Oh, we also won the tournament. Nice. Throughout the rest of the regular season, we had our ups and downs, finishing with 14 wins, 2 losses, and 3 ties. We were able to create many funny memories on the field and on the bench, but our success in the past wouldn't mean anything if we lost in the playoffs. As we battled freezing temperatures, wet and sloppy conditions, and fierce competition, our team shut down our opponents, all the while our fan base began to grow. By the Super Sectional game, we finally had more than our parents come out to support us. After dominating and beating a team that had gone down state 6 out of the last 10 years, we were a full-fledged family. There was no denying that over the past 6 months, our team had gone from kids that barely knew each other to a band of brothers. Playing down state at North Central College in Naperville was like a dream. Winning the quarterfinal was also like a dream. What made the dream feel like reality was that our school set a state record for attendance to a single soccer game. We had gone from the football school that had 30 fans at the soccer games to the school that had nearly 2,000 students, faculties, and family members in the stands. Our team used soccer to bring our school and city together. It may not seem like a Herculean task, but for a group of 22 kids to complete such
a feat is amazing. While we didn't end up winning state, we came in third. Only 2 teams in the entire state could have ended their season on a victory, and we were one of them. We had been through the good, the bad, and the ugly, and we still managed to survive. We were a family. Many think soccer is just a sport, but to others, it is much more than that. It's a passion. It's a love. It's a way of life. Soccer unifies. It brings people of different cultures, backgrounds, and nationalities together in a time where the presence of brotherhood is few and far between. You can't succeed on your own. You need your teammates. You need your coaches. You need your fans. Soccer creates relationships, bonds, families, and memories that last a lifetime.